engaging in engorging that meal. The trap Satan laid for him was sin. The demons draw energy and strength from sin. Now look at sin. So I obeyed, focusing on Seth. I saw that there were demons floating around him as well, but they were all very thin and emaciated. Beautiful blue-gold sands surrounded Seth and seemed to be choking him, but at the same time, they were wafting straight up to heaven. This is the fragrant incense of a soul committed to holiness, to obedience and humility. The demons cannot stand this fragrance and will soon flee from it. This incense goes straight to heaven and is breathed in by the very nostrils of the Lord God, and all of heaven can smell it. Sure enough, the demons did flee, Seth, and went over to Cosmo, who was now looking even more dreadful and even more sluggish. The demons surrounding him were now quite fat and large, and the thin ones that had fled from Seth began to feed also from him. The angel. This is also one of the reasons that Satan and his demons provoked the sons of men to produce sin. It is not only to damage men, drive a wedge between them and God, and open the door for them to be saved, but also to recharge themselves with sin. It is an energy source for them. Cosmo was not looking at all good by this point, but he continued on walking. Seth was now a good ways ahead of him. The angel. Warfare approaches. A cloud of little winged impish creatures was blocking the path of the two warriors. There must have been thousands of them. They chanted a mantra. Fear, doubt, unbelief, over and over again as they watched the warriors approach. I could see them stand still for a moment as a few of the fear demons flew by them. Not too close, due to the incense of virtue surrounding them, but a few ventured close. I perceived that the two warriors could not see these creatures. Then the fear demons swarmed around Cosmo, who visibly became afraid and took hold of his sword, swinging it wildly but missing the demons completely. When he did make contact, the blade did not even cut the exposed form of the demon. He was completely ineffective. Seth, however, took hold of his walking stick and lifted it high. Praying a simple prayer, he began to walk into the swarm, unafraid. Suddenly, from under his sackcloth cloak, his sword and shield flew forth, striking and blocking the demon who got too close. Those who stood in his way, he bound in the name of Jesus, and they were bound in. At this point, I realized that Seth's sword and shield had no grips or handles, yet they flew forth with such speed, power, and accuracy, and performed in combat as no man could. I asked the angel why this is so. The angel replied, "The grips for the sword and shield are in his heart. When he began to lift up the name of the Lord and place him between the enemy and himself, the Lord stepped down and sent his holy angels to fight for him." I realized then that the walking stick represented Christ. I could see now, written on Seth's walking staff, an inscription that read, "The Branch." I could also see many angels around him, striking and dragging away the demons that were bound. Before long, the demons parted from Seth and resisted him no more. Seth, looking back, saw that Cosmo was still under heavy assault, being bitten and covered in excrement, which was beginning to eat away at his armor, like hot oil through butter. Seth, weeping for the wounded state of his companion, knelt down and prayed for Cosmo to be delivered. Many angels came then and began to drag the demons far away from Cosmo. The angel. He, Cosmo, had the scriptures engraved on his armor but not in his heart. He wielded his weapons weakly for his lack of worship, and being under condemnation and fear, used them with little conviction. He fought as the world does, and you cannot defeat Satan or his evil spirits with carnality. I heard these words then, philosophy, psychology, and the wisdom of the world. Yes, these are powerless before Satan. That was the end of the prayer warrior's vision, but the Lord reminded me of a passage from the message, "Take my warnings seriously. Evil is on the increase, and the enemy's next steps against you." Please watch or read this message also. We put the link below this video on YouTube. The Lord bless you all.